I've been right since the day I came out, struggling mentally, pain in my house. I ain't in prison, but my mind's in jail. I'm not just visiting, I live in hell.
Young World, LOD 321, LOD versus the internet.
I want to tell you about Jada Pinkett Smith and why a lot of people think she's in the Illuminati or whatever you want to call it, the secret society, the people at the top level who are behind the scenes that are pulling the strings and stuff like that in Hollywood and everything. And, you know, Hollywood is what society is shaped by, whether you realize that or not. And the reason why Hollywood is called Hollywood is because back in the days, magic wands, they were made from holly trees. That's why they're called. That's why it's called Hollywood. It's all about magic, black magic. So the Hollywood got its name from the wood of a holly tree, the magic wand of a holly tree. The wand is made from Hollywood. So that's why it's called Hollywood. And Hollywood has a jurisdiction all of its own. That's how Hollywood runs, shapes the mind of the world. And you know, you can't like walk down the street with a gun out shooting a gun, or you can't be out there with kilos of coke walking down the street. But in Hollywood, on a movie, all jurisdiction is yielded when it comes to Hollywood. Hollywood has its own jurisdiction. They can do whatever they want. They can blow up whatever they want. They can destroy anything, all in the name of making a movie or a TV show or something like that. Things that people work their whole lives to get, they can destroy in Hollywood in a couple minutes just to make a movie. Because that's Hollywood. That's what it's for.
Jada Pinkett has 666 gematria.
A lot of people don't realize about Jada Pinkett. She was chosen pretty much since day one. Even before she met Tupac, when her and Tupac was in performing arts school in Baltimore, that's where they met, her and Tupac. Now, they both were very strong people, and this was recognized since, like I said, since way back before any of us even knew who Jada Pinkett or Tupac was. This is not about Tupac. This is just about Jada, but I'm just giving you a little background. Now, when Jada was discovered, the strength that Jada Pinkett has is she's a very strong person. She exuberates strength as a female. And her and Tupac, coming from the same spot at the same time, were on the same parallel. But Tupac being who he is with his background, his mom, the Black Panthers, his stepdad and stuff like that, Tupac was already deemed to be a problem just from by default of who he is. But also very powerful. He's a problem that wasn't going to be able to be ignored. So Jada Pinkett and Tupac on the same parallel was something that couldn't happen. And Jada Pinkett was in love with Tupac. That's who she wanted to be with. That's who she wanted to live her life with. She said Tupac was a bond with Tupac was no other person can replace that kind of bond. It's only once in a lifetime. You can't get that with nobody else. That's what she said out of her own mouth. But in order for her to prevail, she couldn't be with Tupac, and that was one thing that was bothering her. That's one thing she had to work to get through. She wasn't allowed to be with Tupac. She was able to deal with him and be his friend and stuff like that, but as far as being together, that was one of the rules of her career prevailing. She had to not be with Tupac. So now when she's 1993, Menace to Society comes out, and that's pretty much the first movie that like the hood saw, seen her in, as far as seeing her whole role, her whole character come out. Every girl in the hood wanted to be like Jada Pinkett. Everybody was wearing her hair like her, talking like her, like her whole dialect and just what her personality was on that movie. That's what a lot of the Black girls in the hood was trying to be like. Now, it's called Menace to Society. She's in a society at that point that's not desirable to the people that are running this whole shit. That's why it's called Menace to Society. And she wants to prevail, but she knows she has to make a choice in Menace to Society in order to get to the next level. That's why in a lot of Jada Pinkett's movies, they have her at the end of the movie leaving on a bus. A bus is another thing for a vessel. It's a way to transport from one spot to another. So, and even though in the Menace to Society, they don't show her leaving, but she wants to leave. That's what her whole thing in the whole movie is about, getting on a bus and leaving. So the guy she's with in Menace to Society ends up getting killed. So that stops the whole trip of her, of them getting together and leaving. So that was halted right there. Then in 1994, she comes out with Jason's Lyric, and again she wants to get on a bus and leave. She fantasizes about leaving. She wants to transport. So, and they communicate this to you through movies. They're really communicating with each other, but you're watching a movie, so of course you can see it too. They're communicating. So in Jason's lyrics, it's her time when, this is 1994, she's in the middle of having to make a decision on what she's going to do. In the end, she ends up getting shot. She almost dies, but she don't. But she ends up leaving on and busting the end with her boyfriend on that movie. So during the, while this is going on, this is the time when she has to make a decision about what she's going to do. So they're letting her leave, but she barely left with her life. But she got out of there, but she's still in transition form. She's not really nowhere yet. She's leaving. So by the time 1995, Demon Knight comes out. And on Demon Knight, they're showing you how she made her decision to align with that, with whatever you want to call it, Illuminati or whatever. Because even on the movie, they show her dancing with the devil. They show her dancing with the demon. And on the movie, she's carrying around his blood. And that's the whole thing with the blood. She's the chosen one. She was deemed the chosen one by another guy that was already the chosen one, but he ends up meeting her
and passes it off to her before he dies, so she becomes the chosen one.
And she has this little bottle of blood she's carrying around, and that's how she defeats the demon. After she dances with the demon, she makes her decision. She defeats the demon. She spits blood between his eyes. On the end of that movie, she gets on the bus and leaves and protects the bus. She puts a blood down and seals the bus from harm to come to her on that movie, which is supposed to be the demon coming to get her, but she already sided with the demon. That's why she has the blood. So she leaves again on the bus on that movie. So that's 1995. So then 1996 set it off. That's the year Tupac died. And 1996 set it off is when everything is finalized. She was going through transition on Demon Knight, the last movie. She made her decision. She aligned with the demon. Now Set It Off is, this is where her agenda is really starting. Set It Off was basically a movie about four females taking male roles. She wasn't a lesbian herself in the movie, but Queen Latifah was a lesbian. All the roles, all the females on there were playing real strong roles for females. This was like the first time, as far as a movie like that goes, not the very first, but as far as that and that kind of depth and that kind of, you know, like graphic stuff, shooting guns and really going, they really went for it on that movie. And the whole movie is basically about expressing feminism, strength in feminism, but also lesbianism. You know, Queen Latifah is a lesbian, and I thought she had came out before that movie, but I didn't realize till like she didn't come out till way after the fact. But everybody, I'm sure, assumed she was a lesbian since back then on that movie. You know what I mean? Like smacking a girl on the ass, and it was like really, like I said, going for her on that movie with their roles. It was a good movie. They was really playing some good roles. But that was where her initiation pretty much began as far as official. That's why it's called Set It Off. And when the end of Set It Off, she drives off again on a bus. She leaves on the bus, but this time when she leaves on the bus and Set It Off, they're showing you how, because they show a scene after that where she's totally happy. She's totally free. She did what she had to do. When she left on the bus, in Jason's lyrics, she was wounded. See, on Menace to Society, she didn't even get a chance to get on the bus. It was dead before she got on the bus. Jason's lyric, she was able to get on the bus, but she was wounded when she got on the bus. So she still had to make this decision. Like, you knew she was leaving, but you don't know where she was going to go because she's already damaged as she's leaving. On Tales from the Crypt, Demon Knight, she leaves on the bus, but she still has work to do. She has to leave. She still has this bottle of blood with her. There's still more stuff for her to do. She made her decision. She's going along with it, but now she has to prove it because she's left with the bottle, like I said, the blood. So this is showing you there's still more work for her to do. Now I Set It Off, when she leaves on the bus, that's it. Her transformation is completed. She left on the bus. She did what she had to do. And after they show her leave on the bus on that scene, they show her totally free and totally happy. And she had to leave a man behind. She found love on that movie, but she had to leave him behind. And that's kind of what the whole movie was about, with the females, with no men and stuff like that. She found a man, but she had to leave him. And they're showing you that was the whole transition about the Tupac thing. She wanted to be with Tupac, but in order for her to prevail, she couldn't be with Tupac. And that's why the end of Set It Off, that's what they're showing you. She found love, but she had to leave it. If she couldn't stay with it, otherwise she wouldn't have went nowhere. She would have been done. So in order to prevail, she had to leave the love that she had behind.
Thank you.